Have I told you how much I admire your hat, Victor? It goes well with your clothes. It is distinctive, flashy, yet not entirely ridiculous. If I were a tough and dandy person, I would have picked a hat exactly like yours. A man walks down the street with a hat like that, you know he's not afraid of it. So the brave hunter vanquished the horrifying beasts, all thanks to his fabulous hat. Go ahead, touch that pumpkin, I dare you. Come on, touch it.
What's
Oops. The... Oh dear. No matter, I am sure you can deal with a single pumpkin. Once again, the man with the distinctive hat has emerged victorious. The pumpkin lies defeated and ready to be cooked into a yummy, scrummy pumpkin pie.
Thank you. It is said that once a piece of information falls into the hands of the Volkovs, it forever remains theirs. All other bearers of said knowledge are rumored to wither and disappear. Volkovs are vampires. That explains a lot.
So much for the Volkovs clan, I guess. At least in Zagoravia. You do know they have footholds in quite a few cities, right? Perhaps one day.
It says here, King Boromir fell to a conspiracy of envious nobles and was poisoned. This happened in an old chapel. It should be somewhere in the Onion Quarter, the poorest part of the city these days.
It gets to you, doesn't it?
This place is doomed, Victor.
I think one of your stored items was set.
Thank you.
It may be raining down there, Victor, but up here in heaven, the sun shines all over the place. Oh, don't worry, I'm not your god. I am what God wants to become. You seem fascinated by the macabre, Victor. It disturbs me to watch you like that, always so enthusiastic to enter a new cemetery or crypt. You'll get there, Victor. You'll get there. I want you to meet the broker. He has some steaming hot promotions for you.
Let's make a deal. You spare me, and I will say...
Look for me and...
Thank you.
I'm glad I'm finally out of this gloomy place.
Welcome to the Onion Quarter. Let me show you the sights. To your left, you can see the magnificent slum inhabited by the deprived workers who built the city with their sweat and blood. Is that what you're fighting for, Victor?
Hey,
I saw a survivor over there. Quickly, up the hill.
Thank you.
between two worlds. Life hovers like a star, twixt night and morn, upon the horizon's verge.
The ghostly Tsar found his death there, you know. I wonder what you'll find.
Is set ablaze with fires that give no heat. The forces of darkness have already worked their way into the sanctum. I wonder if the spirit of the Tsar is still uncorrupted, or am I rushing into the next sinister trap?
Thank you.
Mortal, I sense the taint. The demon powers, even in you, do not come any further.
Listen to me, Victor. Your powers have grown beyond his understanding. You must push forward to accomplish your goals.
I shall suffer you no more, abominations. Your foul taint has tarnished my city for too long. Boromir, the first hunter, banish the shadows from this holy place. Begone back into the Well of Worlds.
Thank you.
The wraiths are too strong for my fading powers. You will have to trust the steel in your hand and your heart to deal with the rest. Thank you for this, tainted hunter. I am Tsar Boromir, the first hunter. I had sworn to fight the demons in our world. It was I who built Zagoravia. For generations, my legacy has been passed down the royal lineage of Zagoravia.
But who are you?
I sense the demon taint within
you. I've been running away all my life.
Once upon a time, there was a prosperous kingdom. Its citizens enjoyed a life of wealth, luxury, and knowledge. Until its greedy neighbors joined forces in a vile plot. Three armies surrounded the city and its fall was inevitable. The young prince, heir to the throne, was willing to do anything and everything to save the kingdom. In this most desperate hour, an old man whispered to him,
"Open yourself to powers beyond this world, for this world has forsaken you. Seal your fate, my prince."
Those words burned the mind of the prince as fire. He took the power he was offered and fought like a demon, summoning lightning and fire from the sky. He turned the tide, and the invaders fled in fear. But great power always comes at a great price. The children starved, for the crops would not grow. His father died of an illness unseen. For the price of his power was the death and decay of everything around him. Even though he was the last of his bloodline, the prince left his kingdom. For if he stayed, his people would suffer and perish. Now he wanders the world alone, never staying in one place for long, lest his curse catches up with him.
I understand how you became tainted, hunter. Your past mistakes...
I'm far past amends and redemption, but my heart is true.
There is a way. You must find the physical object...
Point me towards the gate to the demon world, Boromir.
I will reveal the location of the well to you, hunter. But not yet. There are several demons currently in Zagoravia of immense power.
Didn't you like that chap better when he recited nonsensical poetry to you? Tad too arrogant for a 1,000-year-old corpse, I would say.